Moshville Radio. From indie to metal, it rocks.
Back to the UK Thrashers Radio Show. This is Branny. Let's kick things off with some thrash from Infex. This is Blood of the Wicked.
We'll be right back.
said, welcome to the show. This week we have an interview with B'Hellmouth, frontman to those undead thrashers from Leeds. Send More Paramedics. But before we get into that, let's prove something else isn't dead, and that's Thrash. This is Cremated. Thrash ain't dead.
Moshville Radio, from indie to metal, it rocks!
Next up, the latest signal from a band we've been supporting for a while from Gothenburg, Sweden. This is Omnium and Psychosis. from Omnium to Omnicide, taken from their Behind the Lies EP. This is our friends, Novichok.
Mask escalation, edge of liberation, clear propagation, conflagration. Will you fight to survive, perish and die? Outbreak of disease, run your need, super bug epidemic, vector system, magnet consume, nasty still, and the tech mutation, the vaccination.
From the hardcore end of the thrash metal circle, this is Borstal and Vicious Circles.
Time out!
leads us into the first part of our interview with Send More Paramedics. This is Send More Paramedics and the Hordes. This week in the virtual studio, we welcome Send More Paramedics. Welcome to the show.
All right. Thank you so much for having me. I am B'Hellmouth. I am the voice of Send More Paramedics, the zombie they send along to do all this kind of shit.
So, kind of, you guys have been together since about kind of 2001, I think, was your kind of early demo days. Do you want to quickly name check the current lineup and who's doing what?
Lineup is the same as it always was. There's me, B'Hellmouth, on vocals, Medico on guitar, Ex Undead on bass, and El Diablo on drums. Same four stiffs it always was.
Always the same. So as you guys kind of
crawled out the grave together. How did you end up meeting to come up with the whole Send More Paramedics lifestyle, I guess, rather than a theme?
Well, it's all pretty blank, to be honest. I mean, in terms of the immediate cause, we're talking about a spillage of 2,4,5 trioxin in the Leeds area circa 2001, which precipitated an unholy flurry of undead thrash, the virus spreading and causing a wave of contagion that lasted until 2007.
Okay, so over that kind of that period, you guys were putting out a fair bit of music, lots of live tours, lots of kind of Bloodstock performances, et cetera, et cetera.
Uh-huh.
And so what's the kind of, what's the biggest venues you've played so far? Where the where have you kind of infected the most civilians?
So the biggest, I think the kind of biggest thing we ever did was our download show, which was an early afternoon one in on download 2005. I think there were about 2,000 people in the tent. We managed to infect pretty much all of them. So here's a shout out to all those ghouls who were there. We did Leeds and Reading, which I think would be a slightly smaller venues. Those were the biggest. We played with the Offspring. Did a short tour with them, Europe and UK, 2005. But I think the venues would have been smaller. So the biggest thing we probably ever did was download that time.
Okay. So so for those who kind of haven't heard you guys, because obviously you went a little bit silent for a few years. Do you want to kind of describe the Send More Paramedic sound?
An unholy fusion of hardcore punk and thrash metal, deeply tainted by an obsession with zombie cinema in all its forms. The worse, the better.
The worse the B-movie, the better.
Oh, yeah. I'm talking 1970s. I'm talking Italian. The bad shit.
Bad shit. So for some of those tours you were talking about there, you know, the Leeds and Reading, the, you know, out with Offspring, that was quite a... I guess it was quite an odd mix.
Offspring, yeah. I will not deny that there might be a little bit of skate punk in the deformed DNA of the band. So in some ways, there's perhaps the faintest, dimmest memory of a 17-year-old pre-deceased. B'Hellmouth, who might have spent quite a long time listening to Smash, for example, in the late 1990s. So, yeah, you know, maybe incongruous, but maybe not. I mean, I think the audience found it incongruous, to judge by the German teenagers who sat in the mosh with their backs to us, raising two middle fingers at us. And the people in Glasgow who threw 2 pence coins at our bass player. So, yeah, we didn't meet a uniformly enthusiastic reception when we toured with the Offspring, but you know, I think some people liked it and it was fun. So, got to eat brains.
I guess from the point of view of kind of going on a tour with a kind of, you know, I don't know how they were, but they were kind of still a stadium level band, I guess, nearly, you know, or at least they've been to that level. So it was quite an experience, I guess.
Oh yeah. I mean, it was, yeah, insane for a bunch of idiot zombies from Leeds to be touring like that. It was mad. Our rhythm section tried to devour noodles at one night in Zurich, I think it was. So they chewed his ear for a while, but obviously we were the support band, so we were. Stuck in our little hearse motoring across Switzerland or whatever most of the time.
Moshville Radio. From indie to metal. It rocks!
We'll be back with Send More Paramedics in a few minutes, but before that, here's Diabology. This is the softest grave. The UK and one of the original big four of UK thrash. This is Slammer and Insanity Addicts.
Around the bend, your style is cool, each other's friends and still deny.
Moshville Radio, from indie to metal, it rocks!
Excellent. So, kind of mid-2000, about kind of said 2007-ish, you decided to kind of go into some sort of hiatus. Where did you all kind of slink off to in these in the quiet times?
Well, there was the humans cracked down on us. They found us. They separated us up. They canned us up. You've seen Return of the Living Dead, right? Okay, the corpse is in the basement. Okay, we got that kind of treatment, and that's where we've been ever since, really, until this recent reemergence.
So your kind of reemergence kind of started off quite slow, and obviously your social media ghoul has been working his magic and kind of embracing Instagram and the likes. When did you guys kind of decide that you were actually going to kind of all kind of shake off the shackles and get together as a band again?
Well, okay. First, I got a shout out to Mr. Dan Phillips, who has done so much amazing work, our internet ghoul, who has done so much amazing work for us, promoting what we've been doing and making the archive and making the Instagram and on all the different social media. I mean, what a dude. Thank you so much, Dan. Okay. So in 2006, we did an album called The Awakening, which was about a zombie virus. And then 2019, COVID comes along, but where are all the fucking zombies? Okay. So, you know, we just had to do something about this. If there's going to be a fucking plague, it's got to be a zombie plague, right? So that's what started us off. Also, maybe there's a little bit of a connection to it being 20 years since we first erupted from the basements of Leeds. But yeah.
So obviously the kind of the original things that started to be announced were you kind of doing some Halloween shows and all those sorts of things, which kind of sits, you know, straight bang in the middle of your DNA. But that's now kind of grown into, I guess, is this going to be your final album or is it Never Say Never?
Well, it's called The Final Feast. So go figure. It's a pretty strong indicator, I think. There's no current plans to even, you know, to play beyond these Halloween shows or to do anything else. The dead have a very limited perspective of things, but that's how it seems to stand.
So never say never, but kind of, as you say, the writing's on the tombstone.
Yeah.
So this album, you guys seem to have turned it round pretty quick. You know, you kind of, from the look of the dates and the press release and everything, you've kind of, you hit the studio and kind of knocked this out of the park quite quickly. Are you, were a lot of these songs already there? Were they kind of things that had been looked at before the hiatus, or is it all kind of fresh?
It's all new. I don't know. My rotted memory is foundering. I can't remember when they started writing riffs, but I don't think it was much beyond the pre, it was during lockdown. It's been pretty quick. In terms of opportunities to drag our festering corpses into the same space, there was one, before everything was kind of then beaten into shape, and then it was the studio.
So even though you're already undead, you were still worried about catching COVID from each other?
Yeah, it's a nasty cough that. I had it myself, actually, yeah. So, the practicalities of our dragging our increasingly moribund frames into each other's vicinity were limited anyway, but we managed it, and I think and hope you'll like what we did.
I just got my preview today and had a quick blast just before I came on. So I've started to reinfect my ears. So that's a really good start. Do you kind of, how do you think, you know, have you kind of stuck to where people expect you to be? Is there, you know, as I've only had a very quick flick through this afternoon, but have you kind of stuck to where people expect you? Anyone who's kind of heard the earlier material, you know, they know what they're going to get.
Yeah. I think they always knew what they were going to get from the first tape, really. Things we did evolve to some degree, but essentially, yeah, it does what it says on the tin. It's crossover thrash. We always said Minor Threat plus Slayer plus Return of the Living Dead. That's pretty much where it is. I think it's there's some sort of subtle evolution. Certainly, I think the playing, despite the continued putrescence of the physical form, somehow the instrumental playing has improved to my ear. I can't speak for the vocals. continued to decline, I think. I think there's a kind of a mature stench to what's going on compared to the last stuff. But it's, if you like the old stuff, I think you like the new stuff. I don't know.
It's gone.
Yeah, it rocks, man. It's good.
Yeah, and so kind of with that, are you are you looking to bust a lot of these tracks out for these Halloween gigs? Is that the plan? Is to try and kind of drop a load of old favourites as well as, you know, some of the new stuff for these gigs?
Current plan is just the hits. So current plan is no new stuff. There were complaining limbs and lots of cracks and pops in trying to recommit this shit to tape. And I think we're aiming to just go with what we know and what people know. So that's how it currently stands. Yeah.
So there's a chance that these tracks on the new album will never be played live, or live and dead.
Yeah.
Okay. So
They've never been played in as a full band either. They've only been played while being recorded as full tracks with vocals.
Yeah. Okay. So so do you want to kind of do you want to give out the details? Do you want to kind of pimp out the album, where people can get hold of it, titled and all that good stuff, and dates?
The Final Feast was recorded summer 2021 by James Atkinson at the Station House Studio, Leeds. It will be released. It is due for release on Friday, the 17th September, 2021. It's only going to be released for download and stream in digital formats. You can download it on Bandcamp. You can get it on iTunes. You can get it on Amazon Music. You can listen on Apple Music. You can listen on Spotify, Deezer, YouTube Music, Tidal.
So what about the gigs? What's the plan for the Halloween show? Whereabouts is that? And I guess it's sold out, isn't it?
Our spiritual home, not that we have souls, our spiritual home is Leeds. We have now three shows at Temple of Boom, Leeds' premier hardcore and metal venue. I believe everything may now be sold out, I think. So that's the Thursday, Friday, Saturday of October, Halloween. So that would be 28th, 29th, 30th October. And then we're playing London Tufnell Park, the Dome, 31st. So is the Saturday the actual Halloween? I guess maybe.
Maybe it is. Yeah.
Yeah. So we got that run of four shows.
So three home shows and then infect the capital.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. And then that's it. The ghouls crawl off back to their graves and finish decomposing until it's all forgotten.
So it is predicted. Yep.
The new single Totenkopf came out on Wednesday. How was that chosen as the kind of the launch single for this album?
That was felt to be the hookiest, catchiest, and one of the most kick-ass ones on there. So, yeah, that's coming out. Check it out.
Excellent.
That one's about Nazi zombies, of course.
What else? And that classic B-movie kind of fodder.
Yeah, Oasis of the Dead, Oasis of the Living Dead, 1981. That was my inspiration there, and it was fun.
And is that kind of, you know, is that still the inspiration? Is it taking those B-movies, you know, and the more obscure the better, and kind of turning them into a kind of an SMP track? Is that still the way you kind of do your songwriting?
Well, I mean, I think when we quit in 2007, I think we had written about 50 songs or so, and every single one was about zombies. What else do zombies write about? And it remains the case. I mean, there's certain songs where the lyrics are perhaps more elliptical and metaphorical, and maybe not as directly about literal zombies as they could be, but every single song is about zombies, and part of the joy is trying to find, well, not trying to find different angles, because frankly it's an inexhaustible subject.
And the final shows, if we, I said, you're obviously going to bust out the kind of the fan favorites and your own favorites. What about anything else? Is there going to be some, is going to be plenty of blood and gore on the stage and in the crowd, or are you been made to keep it clean?
Yeah, I mean, it wouldn't be SMP without blood, without gore, without theatrics. So look out for that. Yeah. Obviously, when we play, we tend to attract a large number of the living dead themselves. So we're expecting to see shambling hordes of decomposing ghouls flooding in through the doors and rocking out.
You're definitely hoping for definitely hoping for a kind of full-on Living Dead mosh pit.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Monsters of the Mosh.
Excellent. On that note, I will let you return to feasting on the brains. Thank you for taking time to join us in the studio. Good luck with these final four shows. And, good luck with the last album, which, as we said, is due out next Friday, the 17th.
Neil, it's been a pleasure. I just regret that we couldn't do this in person, that you weren't a little physically closer within reach, as it were. That could have been great. But hopefully I'll see you in the mosh, maybe, and we can carry this on.
Moshville Radio, from indie to metal, it rocks!
Cop by Send More Paramedics. Their new album, The Final Feast, came out last Friday. This is Beyond Salvation and Aftermath.
Time for a swift punch in the face. This is Dishonor the Crown and Blood on the Union Flag. Up a band who we're expecting new music from very soon. This is Dead Before Morning and Black Sail.
Now pay with your life.
From Copenhagen, Denmark, this is Demolizer and Cancer in the Brain.
Yeah.
From Copenhagen to the Bay Area, this is some classic thrash from Exodus. Fabulous Disaster. Fabulous Disaster to Surf Nicaragua. That was Sacred Reich. Next up, back to Preston. This is a band we're looking forward to seeing next weekend in Glasgow and Dundee. This is Solitary.
Together, and we'll align the future into fucking Saturday.
Keeping things UK, this is Divine Chaos and Murder for Sale.
Bye-bye.
That was Reign of Fury and Psycho Intentions. Okay, this next track is dedicated to our mate Aaron and our brothers in Shrapnel. This is The Mace. Next up, a band who've gone into a bit of a hiatus due to kind of personal issues. This one goes out to Acer and our mates in Illyrian. This is Black and the Sun. We'll be right back.
We are getting towards the end of the show, but there's only one thing for it.
Slayer!
To Sodom, this is a 2021 reissue of Bomb and Hargle.
Bumble Doggle! Bumble Doggle! Bumble Doggle!
And we're going to play you out with a final track from this week's guest. This is Send More Paramedics from the Final Feast. This is Hibakusha, and this was a UK Thrashers radio show. See you next time.
Moshville Radio, from indie to metal. It rocks!